Hey guys, this is David Kwan. Now this is a really nice black shirt, but for some reason on my MacBook camera it just seems like, I guess it's so black, it just seems like a regular shirt, but whatever. Anyway, on this video, I'm here to really talk about kind of an emotional moment that happens when you're discussing or debating someone. But before I get to actually talking about that, I do want to, you know, just state that I love debating and I love discussing things for some reason. I can't really explain why or how this human psyche works that way, but I just enjoy doing that. I love rambling about different stuff. I love listening to opposing viewpoints and responding to it and having a discussion and debates. It kind of makes me wonder about, because in high school, I had one of my electives as a 10th grader was a forensics class. And I know the word forensics is a little weird, because forensics, I guess when I say that to people, people usually think of CSI or, crime scene investigation, because it kind of conjures up the image of a scientist testing out bullets and figuring out the DNA of a hair sample, because that's what forensic scientists do. But forensics class in high school wasn't actually that. It was a completely different thing. It was about discussion, speech, and debates. It was a debate class, basically. And it was kind of in preparation for debate tournaments and competitions, which would usually happen on Saturdays or Sundays. We would prepare for this debate. It would happen on a high school, and all these high schools would gather with their debate teams. And we would have competitions with different events. And events usually compose of four different things. Speeches, improvs, Congress, and Lincoln Douglas debates. So those are the four events that people competed for. Speeches, it can be original or it can be from an excerpt from a published source. It can be comedy or it can be drama. It can be original writing. A whole bunch of different things. You take an excerpt, you memorize it, and you perform it. You're judged on based on the performers. That's one event. Another event is improv. You're given a topic at random. You don't know what the topic is going to be. And then you have 2 minutes to prepare to talk about that topic. And then you go up there and you talk about that topic. And you improv your way through it. So that's the competition. And then there's Congress, which is my favorite event. And I think I was the strongest in Congress. That's where there's this group of people, and we actually get topics before the event, so we prepare for the topics. But you don't get to decide if you're for it or against it. So these are usually laws or bills. And we get handed a bill, and we have to argue for it or against it. But you don't get to decide. So you get up there on the podium, and you argue for it or against it. And, people will try to ask questions to be against you, and then you have to respond. I love Congress. Congress is great. And then there's the Lincoln Douglas debate, which is structured after how President Lincoln, which was now then a candidate, and Douglas Adams, I think that was his name. I forgot. Stephen Douglas. I don't know. It was Lincoln and Douglas debating each other. There were 2 debates that happened, and the debate structure is based upon that model. And we have debates, and it's a tournament that happens. I love debates. I don't know. I can't figure out the chicken or the egg answer to why I love debates. Did I join the forensics class because I loved debating and discussing? Or did doing forensics class make me a stronger debater and have me enjoy debates so much more in my life? I guess it kind of goes both ways. My dad is a pastor, so that makes sense why I love debating and discussing things, especially things that are of opposing viewpoints than mine. Yeah, and I think it's really important to have debates. The danger is getting too emotionally attached to a debate where it feels like a game where you have to win. Because nothing boosts the human ego more than feeling like you just won a debate. your ego gets really boosted. It's just like, it feels so good to be like, yeah, I argued with you, I made my points, I heard your points, I refuted your points, you lost that debate, sucker. I won. It feels so good. But the danger is when you consider a debate as a game of winning or losing. That's really dangerous because it's pointless. Debates aren't, to me, in my opinion, you shouldn't have a debate to win. That makes the purpose of debate pointless. I feel like you should debate and you should have discussions to help you grow as a person, to understand this broader picture of the topic that you're talking about. That's a good takeaway for me. It's something I always try to remind myself. And I also try to remind myself, like, I make mistakes, you know, when I have these debates. Recently, I've been having a lot of these kind of discussions and debates on the YouTube comment sections of different videos. I've been really involved in there. I feel like if I was registered to a forum, I would be even more involved, but I'm not, thankfully. So I'm not wasting so much moments of my life debating and discussing things. But I do get involved in there sometimes. And it should be always, but reality is sometimes I look back at my comments and I notice that, wow, like, what I said right there, not correct. Like, that's totally wrong. Or, it's like, my line of thinking from here to here, that's a logical fallacy, or that just is, like, it's not compelling. I notice that, you know? And the thing about debating is it does boost your ego, so you don't want to admit that to your opponent. But honestly, you should. I should. And I try my best to actually say, like, you're right. I was totally wrong on that. And to build my viewpoints from that point and to make it stronger. Because just because I make mistakes on one aspect of a debate doesn't necessarily mean I totally change my opinion on something. You know, I might end up changing my opinion because you persuaded me to think that way. It could happen. It's rare, but it could happen. But what ends up happening is it's like, oh, I realized that you're right on this, but then here's something else, and it makes me grow, it makes my argument grow, and it's an honest, open debate. It's honest. We admit when we're wrong. I guess a lot of times my opponent doesn't admit when he's wrong. I noticed that a lot. But I try so that I admit when I'm wrong. Because it's really important for discussion, for any debate. And it helps you grow as a person. If you're using the same argument that you use for a discussion that you used 10 years ago, chances are you're wrong. Because, you know, topics evolve and research evolves. So, I don't know. Being set in one way of thinking is kind of damaging to your position, and to your growth. It stunts your growth as a person. But that's all that said. I wanted to say all that to establish that discussions and debates are important. And the way how we engage in debates is really important. We have to do it in an open, honest way that helps us grow as a person. It shouldn't be to win anything. If you have winning as an objective, I mean, that's certainly one objective to have, but if that's like your sole objective, then you're doing the wrong thing by debating. That said, we do get emotionally invested in debates and discussions. I certainly do. And there are moments when it's surprising to me to find myself having these like gut reactions where just like I'm done. You know what? Let's stop. I'm done. I'm ending this discussion. Bye. Usually doesn't happen with me, but it has happened. And those moments kind of make me take a step back and like, whoa, what happened here? Why did I just have that moment? Usually, it's because I get offended to the point that I can't stomach this anymore. Like, or the person is, this is kind of an arrogant gut reaction. It's like, this person is just so stupid. I'm not going to get through to this person. I'm done. You know what I mean? It's such an arrogant attitude to have, but it does happen. The most recent thing that happened with me in particular was on the YouTube section, the comment section of my video, Why Shouldn't Polygamy Be Legalized? I think I was having a really long discussion with this YouTube user, Aluziki, I don't know if I pronounced that right, but this person and I were having discussion on polygamy and legalization. It was a great discussion. up to the last point, like, and then he made a, this person responded to my response, I respond to his response, and we, it was back and forth. And then he makes this response, and honestly, I didn't respond back. I was just like, and I didn't even say I was done. I was just, I didn't respond back. I didn't reply. I just ended it. Because I was like, this is, his line of thinking went really bizarre to me. I can't really remember the specifics of that, but I remember feeling like, well, I remember that he called me really, he called my line of thinking bigoted, and he kind of insinuated that I was a bigot for thinking my way. That ended it for me. I mean, that part of it. Part of it was that. The other part of it was the way he linked polygamy to arguments for gay rights and gay marriage, and the way he linked all these kind of different things together in such a bizarre and offensive manner made me just quit. I was offended. I'm just like, okay, you called me a bigot. You have this line of thinking, which I find pretty offensive. I'm not going to continue. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. You know, on some level, I can understand why I just, not literally, but figuratively, I walked out of that debate. You know, I'm just like, I'm done with you. I'm done with this discussion. I walked out. I can understand why I did that. But like at the same time, there is still this lingering feeling like, does walking away mean you just forfeited the debate? You know, like I said, winning a debate makes boost your ego. Losing a debate, not so much. Does walking out of a debate like that mean losing? And that's why I say the danger is considering a debate or discussion as winning or losing. But it's like human nature. I don't know. I don't want to consider human nature, but it's like you want to win. You know, you want to make your point across and feel like the stronger guy in a debate. So it's a tricky thing, but I think it's sometimes it happens. Another interesting thing that happened was I wasn't even debating, but I was watching a video, and I really enjoy watching discussions and debates. That's one of the reasons, one of the major reasons why I love YouTube so much. I get to see all these people, all these YouTubers share their opinions, share their thoughts and their arguments, and they argue with each other, the video responses that happen. It's amazing. One of my favorite YouTubers to just watch happen is The Amazing Atheist. I usually agree with a lot of his videos. We have very different opinions in regards to politics. He and I are going to disagree a lot regarding politics, but usually on a lot of the other things, you know, on rational matters, we're kind of on the same boat. We're kind of different on the issue of feminism. I know he's highly opposed to feminism, and I often consider myself to be a male feminist. But that's besides the point here, because I don't understand why, you know, whatever. Anyway, I watched this video of his. His video is 33 Reasons Not to Be a Feminist, parentheses, a reputation. It's... Yeah, I think it's a good video. It's a well-made video, as always. As usual, Amazing Atheist makes his point across. He has a compelling way that he makes his arguments. But this is one video that I couldn't finish watching. I stopped at about 8 minutes or 9 minutes because I couldn't stomach it. It's not even that, like, his arguments are wrong. Kind of, like... It's not even that. Like, it's not that I find him offensive or anything. And I certainly don't agree with the video that he's refuting. The video about, like, 33 reasons why feminism is something you should choose, why feminism is right, why you should be a feminist. That video is a poor video. It's so full of logical fallacies and such. And The Amazing Atheist is right to point out that feminism is not the solution to her problems posed in that video. He's right, but for some reason, well, for good reason, I think, the way The Amazing Atheist approaches and refutes that video just offended me. The things he said, the manner he said it, I was just like, oh, like, I was cringing so much. By the 8-minute point, I couldn't continue watching. And that was weird to me, because I'm usually able to stomach past almost all kinds of videos. And, you know, I'm able to watch videos made by creationists that are like the dumbest, stupidest stuff. And I can stomach that, and the most homophobic videos, I can just stomach through it and just be like, wow, what did I just watch? But I can stomach through it. But it was weird, like how I watched this video and I was just like, I'm done. I'm pausing right here. I'm backing out of it. I'm not probably not ever gonna continue watching that, because like I was so offended and I just walked out of that. So that was interesting to me. Like, I guess what I want to say is I don't want to make a judgment on that. Like, I don't think it's right to have a judgment on whether people walk out of the debate or not. Although it does look bad. There is a video on which Hamza, who's this kind of Muslim speaker or educator, and he usually likes to have debates with atheists. And there is one video in which Hamza has a debate with this biology professor. And they're having this debate, and there's this video is like, an atheist professor walks out of a debate with Hamza. And he does. And I can understand it. Like, he gets really offended because, Hamza lies to his face. And he doesn't want to continue a debate where somebody is lying to him. So he walks out of the room. And in that video, like, the video makes it seem like, the atheist professor just forfeited the debate, and the debate, Hamza won the debate simply because he walked out. But, like, that, I don't think you should be making, I don't know if it's right to make a judgment on whether a person walks out or not. I guess it's unfortunate that, like, that I can't, that sometimes debating and discussing is an emotional thing sometimes. We do get emotionally attached to the points that we make, to the things that people say. Usually I'm not offended, but I guess there are times when I could get offended. How far are you willing to continue to encourage that? There is a point where you just say, look, thanks, but no thanks. Have a nice day. Bye. There is a point. I think there is a limit to having a discussion. I feel like that limit should be really, really, really up there so that you can handle almost all discussions and almost all debates. But we're human beings, We're not going to be able to stomach everything that gets thrown at us. And I think that's kind of okay. I think it's something that we constantly have to train ourselves for, to grow from discussions, to grow from debates. That's really one of the most important things, I think, in our human interactions. So that's really all I wanted to say about this topic. The topic of discussion and debates and how we have human interactions is a really important topic, and I'll probably have even more to say later on, but this is already 18 minutes of me rambling on, so I'm gonna quit there. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and let me know your thoughts on this on the comment section below. All right, cheers.